I will show you how to create a cow NPC with animations, a state machine, some states, and a navigation agent 2D so that the cow can move freely within a navigation region. So before we create the test scene for our cow NPC, I advise that you watch the tutorial previously on how we created the chicken NPC. I've gone into detail on how we created the chicken character, the state machine, and the different states. I've also covered how to add a navigation agent 2D and then allow the chicken to move within a navigation region. Now, creating the cow NPC is almost identical, so there will be parts of this video which I will speed up during development. This is because the cow NPC has been designed to be exactly like the chicken NPC. However, there will be some parts that are slightly different, so just stay tuned. What I am highlighting is how you can make reusable components so that it's easy to add new NPCs to your game. So let's begin by going to Scenes and Test and duplicate the chicken NPC scene. So right click and duplicate this scene and we'll call it NPC Cow. Then load the scene and then let's just remove these chickens here and we'll rename this scene be cows. Rename the test scene and just save that. Then on the navigation region 2D, let's just make some slight modifications. Just click bake navigation polygon and on the navigation layers, go to edit layers and you can see layer 1 is for chicken navigation. So let's add a different layer for our cows. We'll call that cow navigation and just close that and then just set this to layer 2. Then go to scene. New scene, other node, and choose character body 2D. Let's rename this to cow, and then save the scene. So go to scenes, characters, create a new folder, call this cow, and then save the scene in that folder. I will now speed up some sections of this tutorial because creating the cow NPC is identical to creating the chicken NPC, which I've covered in the previous tutorial. However, there are some sections which will be normal and I will talk you through those slight changes between the two NPC characters. So for the cow NPC, I have now created an animated sprite 2D, which has two animations, idle and walk. They are the same as the animations in the chicken NPC. This allows me to reuse our states which we created for the state machine. So I've moved the states from the chicken folder into a global NPC states folder. So when I've then created the state machine for the cow, if I then click on the idle state, I can use the same animations. This allows us to then create states and reuse them on other NPCs. Now let's add a navigation agent 2D. So go to add child node and search for navigation agent 2D and click create. Let's just move this above the state machine. And in navigation layers, choose the cow navigation layer. Then scroll down and turn on avoidance enabled. Let's go to the scene and from the center point let's just see how many pixels there are. So roughly there's about 10 to 12, so we can leave the radius for now at 10. I am now going to add some cows to my test scene. now I need to actually update the cow script as we've done for the chicken script. So here, we need to add these things here. So let me just copy this code and we'll create a cow script. We'll save that to the cow folder, then copy and paste that information here. And for the idle and walk states, make sure that we assign the correct nodes to those properties. So now the cow is visible. And then before we test the scene again, let me just check that we've assigned initial node state. So let's just set the state machine to first start with the idle state. So just check that all the export variables are now assigned to. And we have the script. So the extends non-playable character. This is why we are able to now assign the cow here. And now we are ready to test the scene again. So as you can see, the cows are now moving between idle and the walk cycles. And we have reused many of the components which we have created for the chicken NPC. This now brings us to the end of this tutorial on how to create the cow NPC. As you can see, we have reused a lot of the code and nodes from our chicken NPC. So please feel free to view both of these videos to learn how we've managed to create two NPCs with lots of reusability in mind. If you like what you've seen in this tutorial, please remember to hit like and subscribe and receive future updates of my other tutorials. Thank you for watching.